Hey everyone, welcome to the official Codux channel. Today we have an exciting tutorial for you. We're going to show you how to work with Tailwind CSS and Codux, a visual IDE for React projects. Are you ready to style your components like a pro? Let's get started. Now, as you can see, our project using Tailwind is already open and there are several components already set up, but none of the styles are currently being applied. Let's sort that out. First things first, jumping over to VS Code, we need to add the essential Tailwind utilities to every board in our project. To do this, we'll create a file called Tailwind CSS in our project source folder and apply the Tailwind directives there. These directives provide the basic styles and classes for styling components and other elements using Tailwind. This is like laying the foundation for a beautiful UI. Now, let's make the Tailwind CSS styles available in our Codux boards. First, we'll create a board global setup.ts file and note its path. We'll do so over in our Codux directory. Board global setup.ts. In this file, we'll import the Tailwind CSS file we created in the previous step. Then, over in our Codux config file, we'll add a new key called board global setup, which points to the file that we just created. This configuration will include the global board setup, which in turn will automatically include the Tailwind CSS file in every board in your project, allowing you to use Tailwind CSS classes. Now, a Tailwind config.js file is necessary for customizing your Tailwind project. In this case, our Tailwind config is already in the project root and will be detected automatically. You can refer to the Tailwind documentation for details on customizations available. Now, if your config file is not in the project root folder or is configured for, let's say, common.js with a CJS suffix, no worries. Just specify its path in the Codux config file using the Tailwind CSS config key, as you can see right here. Now, the project we're looking at right now has no special setup, and so we'll be sure to remove this line. Now that we have everything set up, let me show you some of the fantastic features that come with working with Tailwind CSS in Codux. Moving back to Codux, we'll jump back to the project picker and reopen our Tailwind project. This will cause the new configuration to be applied. We'll dive straight into one of our components. Let's say this pricing one looks nice. Perhaps we'll zoom out a little bit just so that it fits better. And let's see what we can do. I'll drill into the component, select an element, and hit View Code. This will automatically take me to the right spot in the code, in the built-in code editor, where I can see what classes are being applied or make whatever changes I want to. The first big feature that's offered here is, of course, auto-completions. Tailwind has a lot of classes, and sometimes it's not super easy to remember them all. Auto-completions save you that problem, save you time, and help you avoid any typos or mistake in your class names. And of course, since we've made this change in Codux, we can see all of the changes in real time without having to switch context to anywhere else. And last but not least, we can hover over any Tailwind class name in the code editor, and we'll see a handy tooltip displaying brief description and preview of the style. It's kind of like having our own personal style guide. Very handy. And there you have it. Now you can see your Tailwind CSS classes reflected on your boards in Codux, making your designs pop like never before. That's it for this one. Stay tuned for more upcoming videos. Don't forget to leave a comment. We'd love to know what you think. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.